I'm Arev, and today I'll be showing you what prime and composite numbers are. First, what's a prime number? Well, let's take a look at one. Here's a common one, 7. 7 is a prime number because it only has two factors, 1 and 7, or basically 1 and itself. So that's what a prime number is. A prime number is a number that only has two factors, 1 and itself. So 7 is an example of a prime number. Another one would be 11 or 13. There's a lot of prime numbers. Okay, now let's take a look at another one. Let's see, which number is it? Okay, yeah. Okay, so 16. It's a prime number, right? No, because if you take a look at this number, you realize this has more than just 1 and 16 as its factors. It has 2, 4, and 8 also. So it has 5 factors total. So it can't be a prime number. So what is it? You guessed it. It's a composite number. A composite number is a number that has more than 2 factors. More factors other than 1 and itself. So that's what a composite number is. Let's look at a few more. This number, 31. Is this number prime or composite? Well, I believe it's prime because if I look at all of the possible factors, I don't see any factors that it has other than 1 and 31. Let's see, 2 doesn't work with it, 3 doesn't work with it, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, I don't think there's any factors for this number, 31, other than 1 and 31. So therefore, this number is prime. Okay, let's look at another one. Is this prime or composite? Well, it's composite because it has more than 2 factors. It has more than 1 and 62. It has, let's see, it has 2. Does it have 3? Not quite. Does it have 4? No, it doesn't have 4. But it has 2 and it has 31, which is all we need. There's probably more factors for this number, but we have enough factors to know that this is a composite. Okay, now I'll start quizzing you guys. Is this prime or composite? Pause this video if you need time to figure out. Okay, so as you might have guessed, this number is prime. This is prime because I don't think there are any factors for it other than 1 and 41. So 2 doesn't work, 3 doesn't work, 4 doesn't work, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, I don't think there's any factors for this number other than 1 and 41. Therefore, it's a prime number. Let's look at another one. Okay, let's look at this number. I think that it's composite because it has more factors than just 1 and 38. It's composite. It has 1, 2, any more? It has 1, 2, and it has 19. And I don't think it has any more. It might, but I don't think it does. So this number is composite. Let's look at one more. Okay, is this number 64 prime or composite? As a challenge, if you're done figuring out if this is prime or composite, then see if you can list all of the factors for this number. Hint, there are a lot. Okay, so you might have guessed it. It's composite, because there are tons of factors for this number. One, two, three doesn't work, but four does. And not six, not seven, eight works. And I think that now we can go backwards, because 8 times 8, so then 4 times 21. So 21 is also a factor. And 2 times 32. So 32 is a factor. And 1 times 64. So 64. Wow, this has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 factors. Oh wow, that's a lot. So this has 64. Well, this number 64 has 7 factors, so it's definitely composite. Okay, and one last thing. You might have been wondering, what about the number 1? Because it can't be composite, because it doesn't have 2 factors. If it's only 1, it can't have 2, right? But it can't be prime either, because itself is 1. So it really only has 1 factor, which is 1. So what would we call this number if we were to categorize it? Well, most people would simply just call it neither, because this is the only number that is not prime or composite, because any other number has itself and 1. So this is the only one that falls in this section neither. So that's just if you were curious enough and thought outside the box. And thanks for watching this video. Subscribe to my channel, Ask Arif, to see more videos.